Trying to keep this waistline up, bro.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
Can we get some beers?
Yeah.
Okay.
A gun rack.
I don't own a gun.
It's your toilet.
Jesus Christ. The guy I mean goes, 35 years, been married 35 years. I'm like, oh wow, I congratulated him. He's like, if I shot her the night I married her, I would have been out by now. <He's> like, and then he just took a sip of his coffee. Jesus Christ.
Oh my God.
You look so handsome. Aww,
the girl.
You look great.
So do you. Oh my God, you look gorgeous in it.
Thank you.
Oh my gosh.
Aww, you look so handsome. Okay.
You look great.
Oh yes. Oh, this is so fair.
You
Thanks for entertaining that, everyone. back around. Let me walk down here. Call him. John!
John.
Johnny. Just walking. I love you guys.
Love you guys. Boys.
Thank you. That was fucking great. Perfect.
Love you, Keith.
Unbelievable.
On behalf of Stephen and Nicolette, I would like to welcome all of you and thank you for being part of this joyous occasion. Nearly 10 years ago, these two adventurous spirits, Stephen and Nicolette, found one another. In the years since, they have experienced many treks together from Italy to Alaska and many destinations in between. And throughout the years, it was ever apparent that the experiences they shared, the memories they created, and the love they built, can you hear me? And the love they built would lead them to the ultimate adventure they embark on today. Stephen, despite your muscular build, you are the epitome of the phrase, I'm a lover, not a fighter. You have the biggest heart, and you share it so freely with those around you. You seek peace and harmony, and these qualities will continue to serve you well as you become a husband, and God willing, someday, a father. It all looks so easy from back there. Nicolette, your beautiful smile says it all. The warmth it emits welcomes all to you. You have a wonderful ability to engage with others and make them feel at ease. These qualities will make your house a home and a happy place for your family. And on behalf of the King family, we are thrilled to have you as an official member. Today, these two special people will be united in marriage, leaving behind their separate lives and vowing to share one life together. So friends and family, I invite you to bow your heads and pray with me to ask for God's blessing of this couple and the union they are about to form. Heavenly Father, as we look around us, we can't help but see the natural beauty your hands have made. We are honored by your presence among us today and all days. We thank you for all the blessings you have bestowed on this man, Stephen, and this woman, Nicolette, throughout their lives. We thank you for setting them on a path to finding one another. We thank you for giving them the faith and courage to entrust their hearts to one another for a lifetime. We also thank you for the gift of Stephen and Nicolette's loved ones, both those gathered among us and those whose presence we feel in our hearts. In big ways and small, they have helped shape who Stephen and Nicolette are today. May they continue to be a positive influence on this couple's lives, offering loving encouragement along Stephen and Nicolette's journey. God, we humbly ask for your blessing of the union Stephen and Nicolette are about to form. Grant that their hands always be joined in friendship, that their hearts always be bound in love, and that their minds always be firmly committed to the principle that a shared life is worthy of the sacrifice needed for it to flourish. May they accept each other as they are, strengths and weaknesses, virtues and flaws. May they encourage and inspire one another to achieve great things while always offering refuge from life's disappointments. And may they rise each morning with gratitude and delight to spend another day together. We ask all of this in the name of our Lord, your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Stephen and Nicolette, I'm now going to ask you to declare your intention to be married. I will ask that you please respond, I will. Stephen, will you have Nicolette to be your wife, to live together as friend and partner? Will you love her as a person, respect her as an equal, sharing joy as well as sorrow, triumph as well as defeat, and keep her beside you as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Nicolette, will you have Stephen to be your husband, to live together as a friend and life partner? Will you join him as a person? Will you love him? Just do both. Love him as a person, respect him as an equal, sharing joy as well as sorrow, triumph as well as defeat, and keep him beside you as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Stephen and Nicolette, as you exchange the vows which establish your commitment to the journey you embark on together today, know that the love and support of all present go with you. Nicolette, I'll now ask you to share your vows with Stephen.
Stevie, for the past 9 years, you've been the person I've turned to for every challenge. Is this good?
Yep.
This work? You've been the person I've turned to for every challenge. You've pushed me, you've calmed me, and helped me achieve so much more than I could have on my own. So man, do I really wish you could have helped me write these vows today. I don't know if I can ever fully explain what you mean to me or how much I adore you, but I'm gonna give it a shot. You are my absolute everything. Everything I didn't know I needed, everything I was told I deserved, and everything I'd ever want in a best friend. You are my matcha latte, you are my midday walk, and you are all my mountain ranges. Simply put, you are all my favorite things combined. When I look at you, I see the best parts of my past. All the joys, lots of laughs, and growth as individuals, not only separately, but also together. Through it all, you have been my comfort, my safe space, and my rock. You've shown me nothing but unconditional love and a whole lot of patience. Knowing I get to feel that love for the rest of my life makes me so excited to be standing here with you today. You're an idealist, a romantic, loyal, and never let me go a day without laughter. I know you'll be the best husband and even better dad one day. So today, I promise to be your biggest supporter in life. I promise to always lift you up and show you your worth. I promise you will never have to walk through anything alone. I promise to let you wear jorts, no matter the occasion. I promise to act interested when you tell me every celebrity's net worth, height, and age. And I promise to agree to disagree on what a yellow traffic light means. I promise to always fight for our love because we're a team. And it will always be me and you. I love you.
Stephen, please share your vows with Nicolette.
I will try. Nicolette, since we started dating 9.5 years ago, I've learned things are always changing. Nothing stays the same. Times change, places change, people change. We've certainly experienced our fair share amount of change since we met. We started off dating at different universities. I was at College of Last Chance. She was at ISU. We made long distance work for a year while you were in California. I joined you out in California, and we spent 3 amazing years there together. And we became an aunt and uncle together to two of the coolest dudes on planet Earth. And we eventually made our way back home together. Things were always changing. The last 9.5 years have been full of new chapters and obstacles, partially because that's how life is, but mostly due to your knack of finding adventure. That's what I most it's what I love most about you. Adventure means new, it means unknown. Sometimes it means utter chaos. It's getting caught in a monsoon after a Brad Paisley concert. It's getting frostbitten, dog sledding in Alaska at 50 below, ringing in your 21st or your 25th birthday at your second cousin's bar in Partine County, Clare, Ireland, because your girlfriend treated you with the trip of a lifetime. It's moving across country, camping in between the mountains and the ocean, sneaking into Death Valley at night and camping out there, hoping you don't get caught, getting snowed in at the Grand Canyon after consuming a few too many brownies with just a little too much jazz cabbage. It's all been an adventure. Sometimes adventure can be as simple as eating burnt toast. because the waiter brings your fiance's toast out burnt. You catch her swapping it with yours. So you call her out, hey, what are you doing? She responds, what? You love burnt toast. You most certainly didn't love burnt toast. You don't even like burnt toast. She's never seen you eat burnt toast before. She smiles at you while taking a bite out of your burnt toast, out of your non-burnt toast. You eventually bite into your hockey puck on your plate. It's not that bad. Nicolette Marie, you're kind, you're thoughtful, you're sassy, you're beautiful, outside and in. You're my best friend. I understand that with great adventure comes great growth and change, growing together and as individuals and sharing that adventure with your family and friends. You encourage and inspire me to do this every day. I vow to protect you when you need protection. You keep me wild. I will always keep you safe. I will always crack a joke when you need a laugh, and I will always eat your burnt toast. I love burnt toast. I love you. You're the adventure of my life. Christ.
Still my dog, too.
Didn't forget, Dan.
The ring is a symbol of the circle of love. Love freely given has no beginning and no end, no giver and no receiver, for each is the giver and each is the receiver. May these rings always remind you of the gift of love you share between you. Stephen, please place this ring on Nicolette's finger and repeat after me.
Gotta place it first.
With this ring, I marry you and bind my life to yours.
With this ring, I marry you and bind my life to yours.
It is a symbol of my everlasting love and friendship.
It is a symbol of my everlasting love and friendship.
And the promise of all my tomorrows.
And the promise of all my tomorrows.
Nicolette, please place this ring on Stephen's finger and repeat after me. With this ring, I marry you and bind my life to yours.
With this ring, I bind my life. Did I miss some already? I miss some of that.
I marry you. And bind my life to yours.
And bind my life to yours.
It is a symbol of my everlasting love and friendship.
It is a symbol of my everlasting love and friendship.
And the promise of all my tomorrows.
And my promise of all my tomorrows. And the bees.
With this cord, we honor the ancient Celtic ritual of hand fasting. The binding of hands represents the eternal bonds that will hold you together as a married couple. The green color is symbolic of growth, prosperity, health, and love, that your union may be fruitful and your happiness abundant. In the joining of hands and the fashion of a knot, so are your lives now bound one to another. With this knot do I tie all the hopes of your friends and family and of yourselves for your new life together. May God bless this union. Stephen and Nicolette, you have expressed your love to one another through the commitment and promises you have made. It is my honor that I pronounce you husband and wife. Stephen, you may now kiss your bride.
Ready?
Yeah!
Good.
Well,
I feel it. We're very, holy shit, watch your step.
Oh.
You okay?
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you.
Go ahead.
Do you need a hand?
I
understand we've got a birthday in the house. Bryce Savage. Where are you, Bryce? It's his birthday today. So one, two, three. Happy birthday to you. To the head table as we hear a welcoming speech from our couple of honor this evening. Please welcome Nicolette and Steven.
We're gonna keep this brief and concise, unlike my vows. Thank you everybody for making it out tonight. We have people from New York, Maryland, to California, all the way to California. Thank you. Florida, Texas, and who could forget Illinois? Thank you. Thank you, everyone, for making out for our special night. This is the best. We're doing something like tonight to celebrate with you guys, and this is so exciting for us to share with you. So thank you all very much for making it out. Everyone, I hope you're having a great time. Let's have fun tonight. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Jess. I am Nikki's co-matron of honor. Not maid. I've seen Nikki's bedroom one too many times. Welcome to the Royal King Wedding. Thank you all for coming and celebrating this wonderful couple. Nikki is my best friend. We met in seventh grade when I transferred to St. Bede's. I was, Woo! I was the tom girl wearing these ugly navy blue pants instead of the plaid skirts all the popular girls like Nikki were wearing. So I would say Nikki and I didn't really become close until high school. There we bonded over our sense of adventure and travel. Us 16, 17-year-old girls would just spontaneously go up to northern Wisconsin to hike, camp, whitewater raft on a Friday afternoon. Shout out to Jeannie and Keith. For letting us crazy girls go on these trips. And to Aunt Sally, if she's over there, letting us make a pit stop at her bar. Shirley Temples, everyone. Get your mind out of the gutters. Those trips are some of the most memorable because we truly learned how to live. Of course, learning from some mistakes as we went. But ever since then, we've made it a tradition to go on a girls' trip every year. Nikki lives for adventure, always willing to attempt some crazy activities on her trips, whether it's hiking glaciers in Alaska, going on hot air balloon rides, hiking Machu Picchu. She truly lives life to the fullest. Nikki has always been the planner of our trio, her type A corporate self, making lists and itineraries for anything that we do. She's made it pretty easy for Nicole and I as maid of honors because she's literally planned basically everything. Sorry, I'm crying as I'm saying this. She is definitely the protective one of our group, making sure that anyone that messes with their friends gets the wrath or grudge of Nicolette. She's also, as many of you know, quite the fashionista. If you're ever in need of extra clothes at a sleepover, Nikki's sure to have something for you in her closet. I slept over at Nikki and Steven's a couple months ago and was loaned our vintage 2011 Grant gym sweatpants. So... I'm pretty sure her closet opens to the world of Narnia. I just haven't found it yet. No, but for real, Nikki is always the one with the best outfits, just like tonight. Nikki has so many traits that make her an amazing best friend. She's beautiful, selfless, gracious, kind. I can go on and brag about her, but my favorite part about Nikki is that no matter how far away we may be or how crazy life has been, she's always there for a phone call or FaceTime, and when we see each other, it's like we've never been apart. Sorry. Our trio was separated during college as Nikki went to ICU, and Nicole and I went to the University of Alabama.
Roll Tide.
It was during that time Nikki and Steven's love began to blossom. There are some people who you just love so much that you can't imagine anyone being good enough for them. And up until I met Steven, I always wondered what kind of lab-made man Nikki would end up with. So when I heard about this younger, rowdy Fox Lake boy, I was a bit hesitant. I couldn't give you the story of my first time meeting Steven because for me, he's always just been there. Forget any other guy before him. I didn't know a lot about him when Nikki and him started dating. I'd only seen him in passing or at parties, but he's an open book once you meet him. He's loud, fun, damn it, he's witty. It like irritates you in a way. He's sensitive, gross romantic, and he has protective dad-like instincts. I can personally confirm this because, as many of you know, I turn into what is called a gremlin if I have too many vodka sodas, becoming a older, angry toddler. So thank you, Steven. I'd like to thank you personally for running after me at 3 a.m. in downtown Chicago and making sure I didn't get into fist fights. together, Nikki and Steven could be described as a power couple, outgoing, kind, fun, always bringing some amazing dance moves to the party, which we will all see tonight. They're both quite accident prone, however, so I wish this dance floor was a little more padded. lastly, they're the most inclusive couple, making friends wherever they go, as what we see here tonight. You could describe their love in so many amazing ways, but I think the main reason they've been so successful in their relationship is because of their sacrifice for one another. Whether it's Nikki sometimes sharing her food with Steven, or Steven sacrificing his evening to chauffeur Nikki and Nicole to a Jonas Brothers concert or something, they give their all to one another, even if it means getting on each other's nerves every so often. Probably the biggest sacrifice thus far in their relationship would be their move out to San Francisco. Nicole was lucky enough to spend this time with them for their time leading up to their engagement. So I'll let her take it over.
Very good, very good. So hello, I'm Nicole, Nikki's true other half, sorry, Steven, and co-maid of honor. Nikki and I have known each other for about 13 years now, but we've been inseparable for the last six, and it all started when she forced me to move across country with her. Nikki had accepted a job in San Francisco and refused to go alone. For those of you that know Nikki well, you know she doesn't like to do things alone. She used to make me sit in her bathroom on the toilet while she showered. So her request to move wasn't that shocking. She would call me daily with the countdown to our going away party, 1 month, 3 weeks, 14 days, so finally I caved. We drove out to San Francisco and had the time of our lives together, singing California Girls at the top of our lungs, exploring the coast every weekend, finding our love for Gossip Girl, having sleepovers every night, and doing a lot of other things I'm not allowed to say in front of Nikki's mom. When Nikki told me Steven was coming to live with us, I was nervous. I had never lived with a boy before, let alone a couple, but it turned out to be one of the best decisions of my life. We became, against Steven's will, a throuple that did everything together. Steven fit into our lives so perfectly, from face mask movie nights, visiting every ice cream shop in San Francisco, weeknight dance parties to weekend getaways. We had the best 3 years of our lives together. And when Steven told me he was going to propose, I was pissed. Not because he was taking my best friend away, because as if, or because I would no longer, or because they were abandoning me in San Francisco, but because I would no longer get to be there to witness all their special moments. I've had the pleasure of watching these two grow into the most amazing couple over the past 3 years through so much laughter and insanity. Side note, if you want to hear some crazy stories, meet me in the parking lot later. To blow out fights with endless I'm sorry bouquets, but always so much love. The kind of love that makes you melt, but also throw up in your mouth a little. Our lives as the three best friend roomies were ending, but I was so excited to see you two start your forever life together. And even though I won't be sitting in the babe cave next to you when it happens, I can't wait to get the call that you're expecting my first niece because Steven will be having all girls. And that you're naming her Nicole. Or that you're moving into your dream home and you've upgraded my bedroom to the master suite. All the big chapter next moments that marriage brings. I've thought a lot about this wedding and how perfect every moment will be because you're my best friends and I just love to see you happy. I love you.
Good evening, family, Nikki's friends, and associates of Steve. Thank you all for coming to celebrate Nikki and Steve on their wedding day. It is truly amazing how far people travel for an open bar. For those that don't know us, I'm John.
I'm Dan.
And we're the best men.
Quiet down. Thank you all so much.
When Dan and I first sat down to write this speech, we put together a list of adjectives that we thought described Steve and Nikki as individuals.
As Nikki's list stands, it included things such as
smart,
she's fun,
pretty,
and caring,
adventurous,
very driven,
very hardworking. Amongst things on Steve's list were
thunder thighs,
husky pants,
oh, thick beard,
some grays,
torn
biceps,
double biceptomy. Strong jawline.
Fucking huge earlobes.
But obviously, those are just some things that describe Steve's classic good looks.
But what you don't see by looking at Steve is his big heart. He's conscientious. His ability to always make people laugh. And what a great example he set for his nephews.
What you don't see by looking at Steve is the kid who would spoon feed me as a baby. The kid who would pull me for a wagon ride when I was too small. And the kid that teachers would bring in to the daycare to settle me down when I couldn't stop crying. And above all else, Steve is the reason why I wasn't allowed to go on Jerry Gaylor's eighth grade graduation trip to the Boundary Waters. Settle down. Settle down. Steve is the reason why I wasn't allowed to go on Jerry Gaylor's eighth grade graduation trip to the Boundary Waters because everyone was too worried that we were going to argue too much. Thanks, Chair. The pitchers made it out to be a great time.
Steve, we couldn't be more proud of the man you become and the exceptional brother you are to us.
When we put together Steve's and Nikki's lists side by side, it's very evident as to why they make such an amazing couple and how the adjectives complement each other so well. Nikki's adventurous mind and openness to try new things has push Steve outside of his comfort zone in such an amazing way. Steve, your willingness to wear Nikki's pants in public makes us all a little uncomfortable.
Nikki, Steve, thank you for making us a part of your big day. We couldn't be happier for you. We love you both. Cheers to Mr. and Mrs. King.
John and Dan King, Stephen's brothers, everybody. That's right.
Get her. better than mine.
In honor of the King family, dancing together as mother and son, Ms. Jim, Kendall, and Steven. Now, Keith, Stephen and Nicolette wanted to honor something special for you. Would you go ahead and grab your bride, Jeannie, please? Nicolette wanted to honor the fact that in just 5 days from today, this couple here will be celebrating their 45th wedding anniversary. That's right, September 21st, 1978. We have this song just for the two of you. Right in the middle, under the chandelier. Once again, in honor of their 45th wedding anniversary, coming up this Sunday, Mr. and Mrs. Jimmy and Keith Ashmore.
Mine like a needle that went straight into my veins.